You can see over here, the very first one is going to be the individual investing account. This is a taxable brokerage account, most common one that most people will probably go through and open up. Next up is going to be a joint investing account. This is if you have a partner and you want to both have access to this account. You can also add somebody as a beneficiary later, and we can talk about that. And then you can see here, the next one up is going to be a retirement account. This can be a traditional, a Roth, a SEP if you are a small business, or you can also even roll over a traditional 401k from an old business that you might have worked for. You can also open up a trust account as well. And then you can also do a custodial account. So if you want somebody to get started when they're under 18 years old, you can actually create a custodial account. Now you're gonna see a special symbol on here saying M1 Plus. And this is gonna be something we're gonna talk about here in just a moment, because this is an additional feature that you can utilize when it comes to using M1 Finance. Because if you don't already know, M1 Finance is a completely free platform to utilize when it comes to investing into the stock market, whether it's with individual stocks or with ETFs. And so if you wanna get some extra features, there is a version that you can pay for, similar to like a premium edition of the service.